Hi, I'm Sam from Rokoko, and we are thrilled to bring you a new AI motion capture tool. Rokoko Video is now Rokoko Vision, and in addition to the still completely free single camera AI motion capture solution, we are adding a new dual camera AI mocap solution that is awesome. You just need two webcams and you can record and download super accurate motion capture all from your browser. Or you can open up your motion capture in Rokoko Studio, where you can do things like retargeting to characters, editing your foot contacts, doing pose edits, and exporting in a greater range of formats. In this video, we'll be walking through the new dual camera tool, and at the end of the video, we'll be talking about some of the ideal use cases for this tech. So let's jump into it. First thing we'll do is open up Rokoko Vision in our browser. You can find the link at rokoko.com or down in the description below. I would recommend using either Chrome or Safari as your browser. Firefox, for example, isn't currently supported, and you can find a complete list of supported browsers and cameras in the documentation, which we have linked down below. And you can find most answers to your questions in that documentation if you still have them after the video. First, we'll need to log in using a Rokoko ID. If you don't have one, it's free and super quick to sign up. After we sign in, we'll be greeted by the main menu for Rokoko Vision. So here, all your previous recordings will show up for you to access at any time from any computer. I'll also mention that I'm using a dev version, so some small cosmetic things may change by the time you see this video. If we click the button in the top right of the UI, we get info about our account. I'm on the Plus plan, which we'll talk about in a second. If you click on the question mark, you'll find links to documentation and other support. But when we click the Create button, we are now presented with some options. On the left, we have our single camera option, so this is completely free. You can create unlimited mocap with it, and we already have tutorials on our channel about how to do that if you're curious. You can also upload pre-recorded footage for that single camera solution. But in this video, we're here to talk about our new two camera tool, which is right here. To use the dual camera solution, you'll need to be on the Plus subscription plan. You can find out more info about our subscriptions and pricing by following the links in the description below. We also offer a free trial so you can test out the dual camera solution to make sure that it's going to fit your workflow needs. Okay, let's stop down for a moment and talk about why you might want to even use a dual camera mocap solution when we already offer a free single camera solution. And the answer to that is just way better motion capture. With AI-driven mocap, the more data you give it, the better the resulting fidelity of your motion capture is going to be. With two cameras, we have things like depth, we can establish proper ground truth, and it means that at least one of the cameras is going to be able to see all of your body parts, no matter if you're turning around or doing different, more active motions. The only limitation with the dual camera tool currently is just that you can't upload pre-recorded footage, but we will be adding that feature down the line. So as I said, I'm on a Plus subscription, so let's select dual camera. The first thing we'll see is a screen talking about what gear you'll need. For dual camera, you'll need either two cameras hooked up to your computer via cable, say two webcams, or you can use a camera and then maybe your phone over Wi-Fi. You can check the documentation for a list of recommended cameras, but I've used everything from a $30 webcam to an $80 webcam to using my phone over a Wi-Fi network. So there's a bunch of different solutions to get you to that two camera threshold. For optimal results, you'll want to use a webcam or camera that is capable of 60 frames a second. However, because I am using two wired webcams, I also have a USB extender cable. So this just means I can increase the distance between those webcams, which will give me a greater capture area that I can create in this room. The ideal camera setup involves two cameras with at least a 90-degree offset. This guarantees that one of the cameras will be able to clearly see your body, even if you're turning around. The next thing you'll need is the calibration printout. You can find links to this in the documentation or as you're setting up the calibration in the browser. And what's best is to print it out on normal printer paper, letter or A4 printer paper, and then mount it onto something that's a little solid. I just used a piece of cardboard, and that ensures that when I'm using it, there's not gonna be warping in the printout and I'm gonna get a good calibration. It is important that you print it out on A4 paper and you follow the instructions in the documentation when you do so, because it will matter for the calibration between the two cameras. So for best results, you'll want to mount your cameras so that they are offset. Here I have them not quite at 90 degrees, but that's going to be okay. They're also far enough away that they can see my whole body in the frame. They should be securely mounted so they don't move during recording. And if you're using a cell phone for one of them, you'll want to make sure that you're not using the wide-angle lens on the camera. Neither of these webcams are wide-angle, so I'm okay. My background is not moving and is mostly a single color, and I also want to make sure my clothes aren't too baggy and also stand out from the background. I wouldn't want to wear all white in this environment, for example. Finally, I tried to get as much light as I possibly could in my capture space. It just makes for better video quality and therefore better motion capture. Once you've got your cameras set up and plugged in, hit Let's Get Started. Here, you'll see two windows where you can select your cameras. You may have to enable your browser to have access to your cameras first, or you might have to reload the window to get the browser to recognize your cameras. Here, you can also double check to make sure that your entire body will fit into the frame of both cameras. Once you have your cameras up and running, you can hit Next, and then follow the on-screen instructions to calibrate. You only have to calibrate your cameras once for each time you set them up. Once we're done calibrating the cameras, we need to do a ground calibration. Then I will go and I'll put my little calibration pad down on the ground where both cameras can see it clearly. But note that the direction the arrow is pointing will be forward in your scene, and you'll have to do a floor calibration once per session. After a successful calibration, we are now ready to record. We'll hit record, and then after a countdown, you can record your scene. Because I knew in my recording I wasn't going to be turning all the way around, I chose to just look between the cameras as I recorded. AI mocap works best when your face is visible to at least one camera, although you can totally turn all the way around and it will continue tracking you just fine. Once you're finished recording, we'll be able to review our videos. You can rename the video, change the looping, scrub through, but the most important thing is that we can trim out bits that we don't want. And so I can just trim down the timeline and then I can hit turn into animation. The videos will then process, and this can take 5 minutes or so. It depends on how big your recording was. I usually try to keep my recordings between 30 and 60 seconds just to save on processing time. And I always know I can just jump right back in if I don't like what I got. So you never need to worry that if you're gonna record more motion capture, it'll bump you up to a new tier or something like that. You can record 1 or 1,000 mocap takes all for the same exact price. You can also jump back to the home screen of Rokoko Vision and your animation will appear there once it's ready. Once our mocap is ready, we can jump into the scene and there we go. So we can navigate the scene by right-clicking to move the camera around and left-clicking to orbit. So this is awesome. We have a great mocap take. No drift, we have ground truth. This looks great. In this one, I'm doing some kicks, and most importantly, I'm turning all the way around, and you can see that we still have fantastic tracking. Again, we have some settings for the timeline and for renaming and doing things like that. But most importantly, up here at the top, we can download this animation. So this is really cool. You can download your mocap directly from the browser without even going into Rokoko Studio. And once you do, you've got a great mocap take that you can bring into Blender, Unreal Engine, or whatever CG software you're using. But if you want to unlock the more advanced features and get the most out of your mocap, you can open up the clip in Rokoko Studio. So you can download Rokoko Studio from rokoko.com. If you're logged into the same account that you made your mocap with, you should see a new project file appear on the front page. If we jump into the scene, we can click on the last clip, and here we go. Now we have our motion capture within Rokoko Studio. And this allows us to do a couple really cool things. The first of which is editing our foot contact. So you can see down at the bottom of the timeline, we have these foot contact markers, and you can adjust these to make sure you're getting the best results. We have lots of tutorials on our channel about how to adjust these markers. If we click this wand, you can also toggle locomotion and foot contact on and off. So if we toggle it off, you'll see that we will lose that absolute foot contact with the ground, but we'll still get this really natural result, and you don't have to mess with the foot contact at all if you don't want to. The next thing we can do is add a character to retarget to within Rokoko Studio. Here I have a simple character that I auto-rigged on mixmo.com for free. I downloaded a T-pose, and if we import that character and drag it onto our actor, there we go. Now we have an actual rigged character performing our motion capture, which makes it really easy to just keep moving in your workflow. Finally, if we want to make some adjustments, we can actually toggle on some pose and retargeting options, like for your shoulders, your arms, and your neck. And that way, even if our character has some different proportions, we can fix some really basic things. Finally, we can rename our take and then export it out by right-clicking on it and adding it to the export list. Here we have a lot more advanced options. You can export as a BVH or FBX with different skeletons. And as soon as we're ready, we'll hit export clips. And there you go, we're done. So there you go, that's how you use the new Rokoko Vision 2-camera AI motion capture tool. It's been working super great and we can't wait to see what you guys come up with. Again, there is that 14-day free trial if you just want to take it for a spin. And we'll be posting lots more Rokoko Vision content on the YouTube channel and on our socials soon. So until then, see ya, have fun out there.